The death of an 18-year-old final year student from the O'Reilly Senior High School in Accra, who was stabbed on campus on Monday and pronounced dead on arrival at a hospital, today triggered a crucial meeting between the Ghana Education Service and the management of the school over how discipline is maintained on campus. The victim, Edward Bokete Saki, a general arts student, was engaged in an argument with a colleague. And guess what? The argument was reportedly over whose father was wealthier. This happened after they had finished writing a paper on Monday. It degenerated and Edward was stabbed multiple times. Juan Godwin, said to be in the visual arts class, is the suspect and he is currently in police custody.
He had a paper in the morning. He was done with his paper. And he came to me and was like, I'm done with the paper. And I said, okay, I'm left with a few minutes. She's a final year student, a form three student, general arts theory. And he came to me, sister, I'm done with my paper. And I said, okay. He told me you're done with the paper. And I said, okay. And I told him, okay, I'm also going to start my paper. Yeah, not a few minutes, we heard there is some noise at the back. And we asked, what's wrong? And they said, it's Godwin and Edward, they are fighting. And I said, oh, what's the fight about? And they said, oh, it's nothing serious. And I said, oh, okay. And the whole thing, no. But the whole thing was like, you, what do you have? Oh, me, I have the phone, I have that. Oh, you are lying, you don't have the phone. So that brought up the fight. That was the only thing I did. So the moment that I was there, I thought, oh, maybe the whole thing is done. It's not, no problem. And I said, okay, for a few minutes, and the guy, that the Godwin guy came, and he was like, you want your brother. If you don't want your brother's blood will flow in my hand. I was like, oh, why? It hasn't gotten to that. And he said, I should want my brother. So there are teachers in the school. Yeah, so when the incident, when the chaos was starting, my brother ran to the teachers. The teachers were sitting under the tree. That's in the school compound.
About how many teachers did you see there?
At me, I didn't look at the teachers, but I knew there were teachers sitting there because they were practicing. We have paper, so definitely there are teachers sitting. I didn't capture the teacher's face because of what he told me. And I was calling the guy to stop. They didn't mind me. So I decided, okay, if they are not minding me, I have a big uncle here. So let me go to my uncle and go and report. So this is what is happening in the school since the teachers are not doing anything. That scared me because the guy is not someone that you would joke with. When he's coming to school, he had this small bag. Because the guy is in visual art too, that's in my class. When he's coming, he has this small bag that contains a lot of like things that
things he can use to do his work, sculpture stuff.
Yes, he has things that is with him that can help. So to me, I know him. He's from Teshi, so he told me, I'm Teshi guy, and also I'm I'm a fishy guy. I will show, if you don't want your brother, I will show him.
The father of Edward has explained how he heard about the incident and said as of almost 24 hours after it happened, he had not received any official information on the incident from the school authorities. Together with some family members, they mobilized themselves and went to the school campus to demand information and justice.
You are Edward's father.
Yeah.
What happened?
Yeah, what happened was yesterday, I see my boy off to campus. So I was not supposed to go to work. So I'm at work and my niece called me that Edward is having misunderstanding. One of the students is having misunderstanding with Edward. So I should come. And so I said, are there no teachers at the school? And she said, the teachers are not sitting there unconcerned. And what is happening is unfair, so I should come. So I said, okay, then I'm coming. On my way, when I got to the motorway, she called that the boy that is fighting with Edward, I've stopped Edward. Lying down at the school premises, breathing. And the teachers are still sitting unconcerned. I said, wow. Then I said, I'm coming. So on my way, when I get to Kotobabi, she called again that there's the student. I've gathered herself and picked him up. So they are going to Lekma. So I should rather come to Lekma and meet them there. So when I drove and I reached Lekma, I went to the emergency. The doctor said, Edward had passed away. And that is it. So when they showed me the body, the boy stabbed him 3 times on his chest. So that led him to his death. That's all.
What have the school authorities been telling you?
The school authority have not said anything from yesterday up to now. The police have not called. The school authority have not called. Even the boy who killed my son, none of the family have even reached me. That's why we are here, to seek for justice for my son.
What intentions do you have going forward?
We
want access from the school.
From the school authority.
The parent of the boy. And the parent of the boy. And the police. What happened? I just want to know what happened. To the extent of leading to a student stabbing his friend. That's all we want. We want the justice. And we want the school authority to explain to us. Either the teachers are not at the school and it happened, or they are there and it happened, or they don't care. That is all we want. We want answers from the school authority. That's all we want.
So you've come here a day after the incident. Have you been able to go into the school to engage anybody?
They have bring policemen to block every gate, stopping us to even go in. I don't think you, the media, you're giving the idea, allow you to go in there. They put policemen here. They're not allow anyone in there. There's nobody who is ready to come out to even what? Talk to us. So that is why we are here.
That's the most painful part, not getting the answers you seek. A very sad story, but how was your family dealing with this loss?
It's sad. You can see. These are my family and friends.
These are friends and family.
These are friends and family. You understand? Hey.
You can't treat somebody's child like that.
I don't know what to say. This is my family. Everyone is here. We are all here for the school to come and do it. Explain.
Graphic Communication is giving you the opportunity to have news not only in hard copy but also in a digital form. Download your Graphic News Plus now. Graphic News Plus, connecting people through news.
And away from O'Reilly, Parliament today sat following the recall of the House to deal with pertinent government businesses, which constitutionally mandated the Speaker to heed to the call. However, when the House met, Speaker Alban Bagbin had concerns over what he said was the abuse of the invocation of Article 112, Section 3, which deals with the recall of Parliament within a session of the current Parliament. His reason is that the frequent invocation of Article 112, Section 3, to recall Parliament could disrupt planned legislative annual budget and workflow, drain national resources, and affect the overall productivity of Parliament.
Despite the efforts of the House, some businesses could not be completed. And I indicated to the House my no objection to the House being recalled to sit mid-September under Article 1123 to exercise this option immediately a day after the adjournment is, to say the least, unfortunate and in bad faith. But as the law stands now, once Article 1123 of the Constitution 1992 is triggered, I am constitutionally obliged to honor their request. We are here at the request of more than 15% of members of parliament for an extraordinary sitting of parliament to address business which merit our urgent attention. The items that were listed on the request for the meeting are mostly businesses for normal meetings. The frequent invocation of Article 1123 within a session of Parliament should be a concern of all of us. While the provisions are clear and unambiguous, we must consider the broader context in which they are intended to operate and legislate to set down the preconditions under which the article could apply. Parliament recedes to focus more on its other functions of scrutiny, representation, advocacy, and diplomacy. It should be recalled when and only when an exceptional or urgent matter or business arises and requires Parliament's immediate attention. Article 112 should not become a tool to keep Parliament in perpetual or continuous session, thereby preventing Parliament and members from performing the other aforementioned constitutional functions and duties to the country and constituencies. A frequent invocation of Article 1123, particularly in a House composed such as this 8th Parliament, could pose challenges to the governance of the country. The good intentions of the drafters of the Constitution could be turned into a horror movie. For instance, frequent recourse can disrupt planned legislative annual budget and workflow, drain national resources, and affect the overall productivity of Parliament. Honorable members, I invite members to, at the appropriate time, deliberate on this matter to establish when it is appropriate to resort to the use of Article 1123.
I humbly submit, Right Honorable Speaker, that the application was well grounded in good faith in spite of the disagreement. Mr. Speaker, let me, whilst thanking colleagues for making it a point to attend upon the House, upon your call, also thank the Parliamentary Service Board for their guidance in seeing to it that Parliament gets to this point. And to all the staff of Parliament, led by your able clerk to the House, that their effort and industry has made it possible for all of us to meet today. I believe, Mr. Speaker, that the issues that you've raised can further be discussed, as has been the practice. Suffice to say that I may have my own disagreement with some of the issues raised as a basis for admitting the business to be considered for this business, for this meeting.
And still in Parliament, the Chairman of the Committee on Lands and Natural Resources, Francis Menu Adabo, today expressed disappointment at the minority member's absence from a committee sitting regarding the ratification of lithium and bauxite mining leases. He mentioned that the committee had collectively agreed to hold stakeholder consultations based on a suggestion from the minority side.
Stakeholder consultation with many people who have expressed interest in this, our lithium and bauxite agreement. In fact, it was the minority, the ranking member of the committee, who brought the idea that we have to engage the stakeholder who have expressed interest in this lithium and bauxite agreement. We all agreed It was unanimous. And last week, Wednesday, for us to consider meeting the stakeholders. But people on the minority side decided that we put the meeting to today, where there will be a record so that they don't pay a lot of fare, come back, go and come again, which we all agreed. So this morning, we had already invited the chiefs and all the people across the country to come and tell us, give us their input into the contracts. And we invited all these people. When the minority people were aware that today is the meeting day, today, this morning, we came here, we met some of their members, and they said they were going to the door where we're having the parliamentary session today to sign and come back. We met many of them, so we waited, and we had to let the chiefs wait for so long a time. Later, we realized they were not coming. It's so surprising that we see them making the press conference that they were not consulted about today's meeting, or that they are busy because of the record. This is not the first time a committee is having a meeting when parliament is in session. All the time when parliament is in session, a committee can hold a meeting. So it's not the first time. So we realize that there is a hand from a remote place which is operating them. A hand. You don't want the bauxite at Nyinahini to be given to any other person but that hand. But we think that Ghana belongs to all of us. So they are not ready today or tomorrow to join us, approve this contract. That is why they are showing this. It's not that parliament is in session and because of that, you can't come and join the meeting. It's not the first time. So we on the majority side, on the committee, will do all that we can to take this report to plenary for discussion, because Ghana belongs to all of us. And we think it's fair that if there is anything, everybody has an input and everybody can also benefit from all the contracts. We can't give the whole of the Unibox site, which is so large, to one contractor. And it's the very reason why they are not joining us in these discussions. So we want to put on record that they were informed. They even muted the idea that we have to meet today. So they are aware the meeting is coming on. Some of their members came around before deciding to go and sign their names at the conference center and come back. So it's a lie if they say we did not inform them. They are aware, and they even started coming here. Before I came here in the morning, I met some of their members walking out. So they are aware. So I want Ghana to know that we are ready to work for Ghana. We are ready to see these contracts.
Thank you for watching. For more news, please visit our website, graphic.com.gh, and follow us on social media. Our handles are Daily Graphic Ghana on Facebook and Instagram, Graphic GH on YouTube and X, and Graphic Online on TikTok. Thanks for watching. My name is Enoch Dafa Frimpong.